Hello dear students, today's topic, the magical flowcharts for organic chemistry. Magical because so many students have benefited from these flowcharts because they make organic chemistry really easy and fun to remember, understand as well as apply. You no longer go through a phase where you have done organic chemistry for months and months together, but still when it comes to putting it down on paper during examination time, you are totally blank. No, these are quick recall flowcharts and these are freely available on the Google site Learning Chemistry is Fun. You just have to Google for the site Learning Chemistry is Fun and these charts are there on the topic organic compounds and their study. How to use the flowcharts? You will find flowcharts on alcohols, aldehydes, ketones, everything. This video is on how to use those flowcharts to your benefit. Of course, primarily, first and foremost, that is required from your end is a piece of paper and pen when you sit down with these flowcharts. Unless and until you do and you write the reactions yourself, nobody can learn them for you. How do you use those flowcharts? I have drawn a sample flowchart from one of those here. This is not a complete flowchart. I've just taken a small part from the heading alcohols in the flowchart. So I have alcohols in the middle. So what we are talking about here is the study of alcohols, their preparation and properties. On the left hand side of the flowchart, you will find various methods to prepare alcohols. So alcohols can be prepared from aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acid, esters, alkenes and so on and so forth. How do we prepare from aldehydes? We reduce it with the help of, this is called catalytic hydrogenation. So you reduce it with the help of hydrogen gas in the presence of nickel, platinum or palladium. Or use reducing agents like sodium borohydride, lithium aluminium hydride. Similarly, ketones can also be reduced to give you the corresponding alcohols. Aldehydes give you primary alcohols, ketones give you secondary alcohols. How to understand and how to use this? I have aldehydes, so supposing I start with CH3CHO. And I carry out its catalytic hydrogenation. That means we add hydrogen in the presence of nickel or platinum or palladium and we heat it. So this ketone CH double bond O, you simply have to reduce it. It gives you CH3CH2OH. So when you have this flowchart in front of you, you can write most of the reactions yourself provided you have studied the topic once. You do need to study the topic once at least. If you have a ketone, ketone means I will have a double bond O over here and let us suppose I am taking acetone, CH3COCH3. When this is reduced with the help of nickel or platinum, we have CH3CH3CH and OH. That means hydrogen gets added across O. The mechanism and all of it is a separate heading for this video. So we have a secondary alcohol being generated from a ketone. Second example we've taken is carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acids can be reduced with lithium aluminium hydride. But since this is an expensive reagent, we alternately convert a carboxylic acid to an ester. And an ester can be easily catalytically reduced to form to give us the corresponding alcohol. Now here if you notice, we've put one preparation in black, one preparation in red, the third preparation in blue. This is for instantaneous and easy recall. Experimental studies have shown that colors get embedded in the brain for a longer and a clearer way as compared to simple writing. That is why I would encourage you, if you download the flowcharts, try and draw these flowcharts with colored sketch pens or felt tip pens so that you are able to relate to colors. Third example, we have alkenes. Alkenes can be converted to alcohols by two methods. One is acid catalyzed hydrolysis, that means you add water in the presence of a mineral acid like dilute H2SO4. Or the second method is hydroboration oxidation. The first one is Markovnikov addition, the second one is anti-Markovnikov addition. So oxidation using diborane and hydrogen peroxide. Once you have studied the topic, you will be able to write the reactions yourself. Come to the second part of this flowchart. Here we have listed properties. So the first category of properties is wherein, in the case of alcohols, RCH, this is the kind of bonding which is there. So what we have over here is, depending upon whether it's a primary, secondary or a tertiary alcohol, there are two types of reactions. One where the bond between oxygen and hydrogen breaks, the other where there's a bond cleavage between C and O. So we have divided this into two categories, the cleavage of OH bond and the cleavage of CO bond. For easy recall, for applying to questions wherein you have which will react faster, we have listed here that primary alcohols react faster than secondary compared, and the tertiary are the least. Whereas when you're talking about the cleavage of the CO bond, the order is reversed. Now, first set of reactions, cleavage of the OH bond. We have two categories of reactions in this. So when I'm talking about reaction of an alcohol with active metal, so active metal like sodium, potassium, magnesium. So what do you have to do over here is simply take the alcohol C2H5OH and react it with sodium metal to give us C2H5ONA. As simple as that, and hydrogen gas is liberated over here. So this makes your study as well as recall of organic chemistry easy. Come to acetylation. Acetylation can be done with carboxylic acid, acetyl chloride, acetic anhydride. So instead of sodium, next reaction that you can write is C2H5OH plus CH3COOH in the presence of concentrated H2SO4. If you notice over here, we are not referring to any book or anything as such, and we get CH3COOC2H5 as our product. So we have esterification, or acetylation is the general name given to this kind of reaction. The next category, cleavage of the CO bond. Now when you study the flowchart, there are many reactions listed before this. We have one reaction where is oxidation. If you notice the behavior of primary alcohol, secondary alcohol and tertiary alcohol with oxidizing agents like acidified potassium dichromate, acidified potassium permanganate is different. So primary alcohols give you an aldehyde containing same number of carbon atoms and an acid containing same number of carbon atoms when the conditions are more drastic. Secondary alcohols, on the other hand, just give you ketone. They do not easily get oxidized to the corresponding carboxylic acid. Tertiary alcohols, on the other hand, do give a ketone, but that contains lesser number of carbon atoms. Now all this is listed in the flowchart, as well as this reaction serves as a test for alcohols, especially to distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols. Like here, the orange solution will turn to green because of reduction by the corresponding alcohol. So this reaction serves as a test. Similarly, this reaction also serves as a test for alcohols containing an active hydrogen. So here, active hydrogen gets replaced by the active metals like sodium to liberate hydrogen gas. So this also becomes as a test. So in this flowchart, if you notice, you have the compound, you have the various methods of preparation, you have the limitations also in some cases, you have the properties listed. We also have the distinguishing characteristics like we've done for 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree alcohol. In this flowchart, you will also find the test for various types of compounds. You will also find the order of reactivity of the compounds. So when it's exam time and you're close to preparation of physical, organic, inorganic, so much is going in your head, then it's very difficult to study each and every topic. These flowcharts have really been found to be very, very helpful. So I would suggest that you download, make the flowchart yourself and try writing the reactions in order to understand the topic more thoroughly. Any feedback on this, you're most welcome. I'm very open to feedbacks and I'm happy to improve myself. Thank you.